Manis off the line, managing to get the whole shot. Even from the outside, okay, only three cars, but, you know, hooked it up and then shut the door. And everybody's sensible here, you know, often in the early races you get a bit of carnage, but these guys, they know it's about time and they've got to get it done. Yeah,
there was a lot of mistake that Sebastien made, yeah. A little over-rotation going into turn two, which has obviously cost him. But a tough weekend for him too. He had a clutch problem in Q2 yesterday, so not much track time. But Valmanis, as you said, doing what he needed to do. He's got a clear track, three cars. It's important that he secures a slot in the semis.
It is indeed. This was him on his Joker. His consistency was good, I say, across the three standard laps. Joker lap two. And he's on the money for the times he was setting yesterday when he was up towards, well into the top 10, in fact. So hopefully a good result for Valmanis here in Q4. He's only got to wait three more races to find out if he's going to make it through to the semi-finals. So off the start then, the two MSC cars. Shishrit looked like he got it, but look at Kevin Eriksson. He's like not having any of it. And I think it was a bit of contact between him and Larson, where Larson lost out. It's the way it goes.
Look, and that's what's also difficult. Shishrit did have a good start, but he doesn't have enough of an advantage to turn that into a lead.
Can I just say, Larson styled that out big time as well, didn't he, you know?
Are we giving any points for style?
100%, yeah, definitely.
Well, he's the winner for sure.
Yeah.
But you nailed it. Did so well there. So smooth through that Joker lap. Did everything he needed to do. And drags on Nicholas Gronholm. Well done.
Great job by Shishrit. So off the line, Tim Zyanov and Kevin Hansen. Kevin Hansen being beat by Timur, it seemed. And then Timur somehow ended up out wide. Timo Scheider doing a good job in this, of course, to beat the time as well of Gulen Shishrit, which means that he's also looking to nick that spot in the semis. I mean, Scheider's just in at the
minute. He was on the bubble, yeah.
The danger man actually is Kevin Eriksson. I think Kevin Eriksson's going to lose out, and Scheider and Shishrit are going to go through in 11th and 12th. But, you know, we'll see. You're going to find the points in just a few moments' time. We've only got one race to go. Great drive by Andreas Backerud, beating the time that Ekstrom set in Q3. Will it be enough for Backerud to out-qualify him and narrow the gap to his teammate and team owner by just a point ahead of the semis? So off the line then, have a look at this. Solberg, look, immediately into the side of Hansen. Hansen can't go anywhere because Loved Up is inside. That's a lot of contact on the run down to turn one, but nothing on the timing screens at the minute about an investigation. Side race for everyone. Look, Solberg runs a bit wide. That takes Ekstrom with him. Hansen somehow gets around the outside of them, and then Loeb was putting in the chase on Kristoffersen. That was super close on pace.
He did the exact same thing through turn two, did Solberg, that he did to Ekstrom earlier. Ran him out wide, dropped him to fifth. But listen, Solberg clearly wanted the inside line because he gave a massive
shove. To be fair as well, at that point, it's very hard for Solberg to be able to see. But anyway, it was really fierce down into turn one. But the fight back from Kristoffersen has been unbelievable. It's what we expect from the legend. Kristoffersen doing the maths overnight, realising what he needed to do. He needed to win Q3 and Q4. He did that. Equal points you can see between him and Loeb, but on countback, Kristoffersen gets it. Sebastien Loeb, P2. Timmy Hansen will be on the front row. So it's Peugeots and Volkswagens on the front row for both the semi-finals. Backerud's got Ekstrom. So Backerud has got Ekstrom and takes 1 point off him. The gap is down to 3 points as we go into the semi-finals. So it's on for that last place. For second and third place, sorry, in terms of the podium at the end of the season. Kevin Hansen, Anton Markkanen, P8, great job. Let's see who's made it. Baumanis, Scheider, Timisoara, and Shishrit's made it. Gronholm's not had a good weekend down here. Eriksson, Larson, and Munich have also missed out.